Tommy Vercetti? Shit.
Didn't they never let him out?
He kept his head down. Helps people forget.
People will remember soon enough. When they see him walking down the streets of their neighborhoods, it will be bad for business.
Well, what are we gonna do, Sonny?
We treat him like an old friend and keep him busy out of town, okay? We've been talking about expanding down south, right? Vice City is 24-karat gold these days. The Colombians, the Mexicans, hell, even those Cuban refugees are cutting themselves a piece of some nice action.
But it's all drugs, Sonny. None of the families will touch that shit.
Times are changing. The families can't keep their backs turned while our enemies reap the rewards. So, we send someone down to do the dirty work for us and cut ourselves a nice, quiet slice, okay? Who's our contact down there?
Kem Rosenberg, schmuck of a lawyer. How's he gonna hold Vercetti's leash?
We don't need him to. We just set him loose in Vice City. We give him a little cash to get started, okay? Give it a few months. Then we go down. Pay him a little visit, right? See how he's doing.
Ken Rosenberg here. Hey, great. Well, I'm gonna drive you guys to the meet, okay? Now, I've talked to the suppliers, and they are very keen to start a business relationship. So, if all goes well, we should be doing very nicely for ourselves, which is, you know, good. Okay, so, they're brothers, okay? One operates the business, and the other one does the flying. Okay, that's them in the chopper. All right, here's the deal. They want a straight exchange on open ground. All right? Okay, stay tight. Let's go.
Got it?
100% pure grade A Colombian, my friend.
Let me see it.
The greens?
10s and 20s. Used.
I think we have a deal, my friend.
Oh, shit! Come on, get out of here! Drive!
I poke my head out of the gutter for one freaking second and fate shovels shit in my face. Go get some sleep. What are you gonna do?
I'll drop by your office tomorrow and we can start sorting this mess out.
Okay, hello. Welcome to this series. So, just bear with me one sec. I'm just gonna... Oh, great song. I'm just gonna turn down... There, I'll try it there. Okay. So yeah, welcome to this video. So my plan is to do a series of Let's Complete Vice City. So here we are, this game was released in 2002. Believe it or not, it's nearly 20 years old, which is just absolutely crazy. So this is my first ever gaming stream. My name's Jamie, I'm 30. I live in the Great Manchester. And yeah, it's definitely one of my top three games. I was going to say top five, but no, I think top three, definitely. Definitely my favourite GTA of all of them as well. So. So, yeah, I just thought I'd have a go at streaming it. Bit of nostalgic gaming while I'm off on furlough, because we're in a still in third lockdown at the time of recording this, so I'll keep quiet so we can listen to this dialogue.
Tommy! Tommy, it's been too long. I know, you're just overwhelmed with emotion. 15 years.
Seems like only yesterday.
I guess that's a perspective thing.
Hey, doing time for the family is no piece of cake, but the family looks after its own, okay? So how'd the deal go down? You sitting on some white gold?
Look, Sonny, we were set up. The deal was an ambush. Harry and Lee are dead.
You better be kidding me, Tommy! Tell me you still got the money!
No, Sonny. I don't have the money.
That was my money, Tommy! My money! You better not be screwing me, Tommy, because you know I'm not a man to be screwed with!
Wait, Sonny.
You have my personal assurance that I'm gonna get you your money back, and the drugs, and I'm gonna mail you the dicks of those responsible.
Hey, I already know that. You're not a fool, Tommy, but I warn you. Neither am I. If it was anybody else, you'd be dead already. But because it's you, because we got history, I'm gonna let you have this.
Look, Sonny, you got my word.
I'll be in touch.
Alright, so let's head down to Ken Rosenberg's office. So I think this is my third or fourth time like attempt at recording this first episode. So the first time the microphone was too quiet, you could barely hear me. Second time the microphone was too loud and there was a buzz the whole time and it was really off-putting. Like, you could just, yeah, it was just overpowering and just quite annoying to listen to. And then the third time, I pressed share twice. I'm recording this on a PlayStation 4. I saw the record button activate and did the full episode, recorded it, thought, yeah, that went okay. Went back and it didn't record. And I literally have no idea why not. So, yeah, I think this is my fourth attempt at doing this, so I pretty much know all the script so far, these first few missions off by heart now, but yeah, I'm going to try and not talk over the script, so let's start the first mission and I'll talk a bit more after.
Go get some sleep, he says. I have been sitting in this chair all night with the lights off, drinking coffee. This is a disaster. We are so screwed, man. These gorillas, listen to me, are gonna come down here and rip my head off. It's ridiculous. I did not go to law school for this. Okay, now what the hell are we gonna do?
Shut up, sit down, relax. I'll tell you what we're gonna do. You're gonna find out who took our cocaine. And then I'm gonna kill them.
That's a good idea. That's a great idea. Let me think. Oh, there's this retired colonel, Colonel Juan Garcia Cortez. He's the one that helped me set up this deal well away from Vice City's established thugs, okay? Now listen, he's holding his party out in the bay on his expensive yacht, and all of Vice City's big players are gonna be there, okay? I have an invite. Of course I have an invite. But there's no way that I'm going out there, sticking my head out the door. No way,
not gonna
happen.
I told you, shut up. I'll go myself.
Oh, whoa. Hey, I like 1978 too, but you know, this isn't gonna be a beer and strippers do. I mean, no offense, but I think that you might turn heads on the runway for the wrong reasons.
What's wrong with the way I'm dressed?
Okay, look, here, stop by Raphael's. Tell him I sent you. He'll make you look respectable. Okay, go, come on.
Who does that guy think he is? Now I gotta dress like a chump as well as hang out with him? I like this shirt.
I like that shirt too, Tommy. Okay. So hopefully this take finally goes okay. And then you'll be... Obviously, if you're watching this right now, then you know it has and I've uploaded it. But yeah, everything is telling me just don't bother recording it. Just play it for fun, you know. And don't bother streaming, but I'm being stubborn and I'm sticking at it because, yeah, just why not? I just fancy giving it a go, just for fun. It's... Hold on a sec.
Nice bike.
Yeah, it's kind of fun watching other people play video games and,
no,
yeah.
My bike!
yeah, it always seems fun to go. It'd be a nice little project to sort of keep me busy, so yeah, that's why I'm doing it. And yeah, and it's a great excuse to play one of my favourite games of all time as well. So I've never actually completed the game. I've probably got about 3/4 of the way through in terms of the story mode, not including the hidden packages and all the side missions and things like that. So it would be really cool to get to the end this time, and if I can record it as well, then yeah, awesome. So well, I'm gonna get to this next cutscene. I'll shut up again.
Noches. I understand you are here on the behalf of Mr. Rosenberg. I hope any recent problems have not affected his health or mental well-being, Mr.
Versetti. He's just got a touch of agoraphobia.
Excellent, excellent. And you?
I just want my merchandise.
Ah, it's an unfortunate set of circumstances for all involved. Of course, I have initiated my own lines of inquiry, but such a delicate matter will take time. Perhaps we'll talk later. Meanwhile, let me introduce you to my daughter. Miss Davis! Cara mia, could you look after our guest while I attend to my necessary obligations?
Of course, Daddy.
Please, excuse me.
Mercedes?
You try living with her. Anyway, let me point out some of our more distinguished guests. That's our Congressman Alex Shrub with rising silicone star. Candy sucks.
And have you met my lovely wife, Laura? No? Well, unfortunately, she's in Alabama. This is Candy.
And over there, we have the Vice City Mamba's star titan, BJ. Always the charmer.
I blacked down on him, and then I put him in a wheelchair.
That is good. Well, now I'm looking at some prime...
And that poolside amphibian is Jez Torrent, lead singer with Love Fist.
Yeah, can I tell you? Do you know how they play ping pong in Thailand? Let me tell you. It does not involve a paddle, if you know what.
Impotent. And the chatty trio, that sleeping sweat gland is Papa's right-hand gimp, Gonzalez. And the other two are Pastor Richards and pseudo-intellectual film director Steve Scott.
Fish throws a passion with the nympho invaders when the giant shark comes in and just bites their dicks off. Now, you never saw anything like that before.
Colonel, your party's as ever a triumph. I can only apologize.
Oh, then another amigo. How do we find you?
Our business is very trying. Barbarians at the gate. A time for rewarding one's friends and liquidating one's enemies, amigo.
Who's the loudmouth?
Ricardo Diaz. He's Mr. Cope.
Mercedes!
Oh, I was just taking my friend back into town. Another time, Ricardo.
Ricardo, let's go.
Let's get out of here. Sure. Actually, take me to the pole position. Drinks.
Okay, so we've had a nice little introduction there to some of the characters we'll be meeting and working for later on in the game.
Will you be working for my father?
Maybe.
Do you mind me resting my hand in your lap?
Maybe.
So difficult having a rich and powerful father. Vamos.
So yeah, my first time playing this game, I was either 12 or 13. Friend at the time, Martin, he had a sleepover, it was his birthday, and he got this game for his birthday.
See you around, handsome.
We got there about 7 or 8
sure you will.
In the evening, and there's about 4 of us. We played it all night, literally all night, till about 5 or 6 in the morning. It was brilliant. Now I've turned the music off just because I don't want, one, I'm worried about you won't be able to hear the commentary over the music, it might kind of clash with that, and also just in case YouTube pulls it up for copyright, so, which does break my heart, turning the volume down on the music, because there's some fantastic great soundtrack to this game. I do love some 80s new wave pop. Okay, so Yeah, next mission.
Ah, well, I hope you're having a good time, because I'm going out of my mind with worry here. What did you find out?
That there are more criminals in this town than in prison. We need a lead from the streets.
Okay, let me think. Ah, I got it. Okay, there's this Limey, some music industry slimeball. Goes by the name of Kent Paul. Anyway, he's got his nose so far up most of Vice City's ass that if anybody knows the whereabouts of 20 keys of coke, it's this guy, all right? He's always at the Malibu.
I'll go pay him a visit.
Take it easy now.
Okie dokie. So it's quite a nice sort of, are they kind of, nice how Rockstar, they kind of ease you into this game. So the first sort of two or three missions, they're quite straightforward. You're just kind of meeting people and dropping someone off, and it kind of exposes you to the map and, yeah, introduces you to the characters like I already said. And yeah, later on the missions get harder. I remember there's a couple of missions in particular. There's the RC helicopter mission in the building site where you have to plant the bombs. That's a tricky one. And there's a one, I've not played this game for a few years, there's another mission where you have to, you get a cop's uniform and you have to infiltrate like the shopping centre. I remember that one being really tricky and fiddly. But yeah, let's listen to this.
Where'd you pop up from? I've been looking for a bird like you for ages, mate. You know why I'm
looking for some English guy.
Kent Paul. Kent Paul, mate. Yeah, I'm the governor, Andy. I'll sort things out. You know what I mean? I'll treat you. Whatever you want, I'll get you, girl. Don't you worry about a thing, mate.
You're lost, honey.
Oi.
You Kent Paul? I'm a friend of Rosenberg's.
Rosenberg. Oh, that bonkers ambulance chaser. That guy could defend an innocent man all the way to death row. Get another drink, bruv.
Everybody's a comedian. Listen to me. I'm missing 20 keys and a lot of cash.
Drugs, mate? It's a mugs game.
What do you know about it?
Oi, well, what I was coming to was, there's some chef come trumpet shifter who deals at kitchen of Hotel and Ocean Drive. He's been looking real pleased with himself lately. You could go and check him out.
I will. And I'll be seeing you around.
That's right, go and walk away, you mug. I knock you spark out. Give me a drink. And where's that slut?
Kent Paul, ladies man. Okay. Let's go back to Ocean Drive. So obviously one thing about this game, which you probably obviously already know if you've played it, that you can't swim, so if you go into water, deep water, you drown. Also, that's something to change in San Andreas, which I think was a good update. It was a bit frustrating. As soon as you get into water, you die, but yeah, we don't have to worry about that just yet. I'm not going to be going swimming anytime soon, hopefully, so.
Hey, what you looking at? You better start talking. Hey, make me, you prick.
Okay. Ooh, kick straight in the face. Ooh.
You stupid prick.
There we go. Got the brick of a cell phone.
Oh, way to go, tough guy. Beat him to a pulp. That should make him real chatty.
You want some too?
Hey, chill. I want what you want, brother.
Oh, yeah? And what's that?
Your green and my dead brother's white lady. Unfortunately, you just silenced our lead.
Accidents happen. Get lost.
Hey, whoa. No need to go all long range on my ass. The way I see it, we two hombres in a strange town. We need to watch each other's back.
My back's just fine, brother.
You sure about that? Here, take this. Follow me. This way.
All right, so we can shoot them, but we'll get a 2-star wanted rating if we do that. And I know there's a police bribe just straight up there, as you can see. But yeah, we can just run off and enter the flashy sports car and just drive off, so we'll do that.
One thing you gotta realize about this town, you gotta pack some heat. The local gun shop is a couple of blocks away.
Alright, so head to ammunition. So we can't buy anything at the minute, but just the game's way of showing you where to get stuff. Different types of guns and body armour and all that stuff. And we've missed it because I turned the music off, but there was a radio warning at the start saying due to the weather warnings, the bridges are closed, which justifies why you can't get into the second island yet. Okay, so that's another mission boxed off pretty much, just need to drive back to the hotel. Whoops! Okay. I've got the game guide as well, strategy guide, so I'll be looking at that for some tips and tricks to how to do the mission straightforwardly. So I'm not an expert at this game. There'll be a lot of streamers who are have already done this game. Oh, I'll just be quiet for a sec.
I'm gonna go see what I can dig up. I'll be watching you, Tommy.
Let's just quickly save it while we're here before we move on to the next mission. Yeah, so I'm not an expert at this game, I don't know all the secrets, and there's people who've been streaming who sometimes, some of them, it's what they do for a job, but who've already done it, who've been doing a much better job than I, but yeah, I'm just doing it because it's fun. So yeah, if you are still watching this at this point, thank you very much for tuning in, I really do appreciate it. Leave a comment down below, let me know you're watching, and I will read and respond to every single one. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do for this mission, I'm going to do all the Ken Rosenberg missions, and I might do that for every episode, so I'll do each character, there's 4 or 5 missions. Oh, let's just listen to this.
Hey, Leo, I think we got a buyer for Diaz's merchandise. Gotta give him a ring, man. Set up the deal, you know?
Where are you now?
You okay, Leo? You sound kinda different.
Just tell me where you are.
Who the hell is this? Put Leo on, man.
Leo's gone away for a while. He left me in charge.
Screw you, man.
So yeah, that's the plan. So, okay, we can head to the next mission.
Oh, for God's sake, it's you. Oh, jeez. I'm gonna need new pants. Hey, those psychos from up north, they've been on the horn, and they're coming down here soon. Now, where is the goddamn money?
Relax, relax. We're not at that part yet.
Oh, I thought that you were taking care of this. I really did. And now those Guidos say we gotta do them a favor.
You mean I gotta do them a favor?
Oh, of course that's what I mean. Do I look like I can intimidate a jury? I couldn't intimidate a child, and believe me, I've tried. Now look, it's either that or Ferrelli's cousin Giorgio gets 5 years for fraud. You gotta take these guys out!
I understand. Help the jury change their minds. Don't worry about it.
No, 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 no! I tried that! The jury case didn't go so well. So make them change their minds.
All right, more crap to wipe up. What did I do wrong in a past life?
Dumb Florida moron.
Oh, someone's stole my Infernus. Never mind. Okay. So we've got a trusty hammer. So we just need to go find two of the jurors' cars and just smash them up. So it's, as far as I remember, it's, yeah, done this mission a couple of times before. This is pretty straightforward. I'm also, the reason why I'm recording this, I'm quite a nervous, sort of anxious person, so I'm hoping, and I'm not very articulate as well in terms of vocally, so I'm hoping doing this will kind of bring me out of my comfort zone a bit and help me put myself out there a bit, and that makes any sort of sense. Definitely need to work on my driving as well. My driving skills so far have been pretty poor. Okay. So, just need to go around and just give it a good whack. There's the boot that's come off. See if we can get the bonnet to come off. Oh, there we go. Oh. I was on his head then. Alright, so. Do you have to give him quite a good hammering before the person notices what's going on and comes out to see what's going on?
I can't believe this is happening!
You know he's not guilty.
Okay, one down, one left to go. So. Jump back into the Glendale. Yeah, not the fastest car, but yeah. Whoop. Looks pretty cool. But it'll do the job for what we need it to do. Oh, looks like it's going to rain. There it is. Tropical Florida weather. Just to the right there. That's where that's that dreaded helicopter mission. Really struggled with that when it first came out. Although when it first came out, I didn't get the game for about 2 or 3 years. My mum and dad wouldn't let me because I was 13 at the time. I was like, no, it's a rated 18. You're too young. You shouldn't be playing that. It's got prostitutes, drugs, all sorts going on. It's a bit too much, which, you know, I suppose is fair enough. But yeah, I was about 15. They let me have it. So, and then I had it for 3 to 6 months, and then San Andreas came out, so I got that as well. So we need to punch this guy once, and then he'll jump in the vehicle, try and drive off. Presto. Now we just need to smash his car. First time I did this, I started smashing his car without him in it, and it just said mission failed. So them doors came off awfully easy. Jump up. Oh. No, I'm going to jump up on the other side. There we go.
Yo, man, I still got payment to make on this.
Let's just give the back a good smash as well. Yep, just keep repeatedly hitting the circle button. Oh, there we go.
Not guilty.
Alright, so another one done and dusted, that's great. Alright, so I think, pretty sure now we're heading back to the last mission of, whoops, Rosenberg's. So we'll get this one done, and then I'll look at saving it, and then we'll call it there for that episode, but yeah. Okay. Oh, cell phone call. Let's listen to this.
Hey, Tommy, it's Sonny. How's the suntan?
I ain't got no suntan.
We ain't got my money either, so I'm one of them myself. What are you doing? So tell me, Tommy, what are you doing?
I'm looking for the money, Sonny. Don't worry.
I am worrying, Tommy. That's my style, because I seem to have this problem in my life with unreliable people. Don't be an unreliable person, Tommy, please. Do us both a favor. I'm looking forward to hearing from you.
Okay, next mission. Let's do this.
It goes without saying. Tommy, any progress? No. Tell me later. Tommy, this is Avery Carrington. I believe you met at the party.
Not in person.
It goes without saying. Tommy! Avery here has a proposition.
Haven't we
we got other things on.
Avery, goes without saying. Tommy, any progress? No. Tell me later. Tommy, this is Avery Carrington. I believe you met at the party. Tommy, any progress? No.
Whoa, I don't know if you can hear that. There's some weird glitch going on there. That's a bit worrying. It was like a broken record there. I've never seen that before. I'm recording this on a PlayStation 4, so it's not like the disc is scratched or anything like that. Hopefully that's not affected the recording anyway. It was kind of funny though. So we're off to Raphael's to get some overalls. Random fact, I've been told, I don't know if this is true, but you can do the mission without having to change. But we're going to do it anyway, just to blend in. But we're going to make a quick detour before we head down there. We're just going to head to ammunition to get some body armour. Because things can get... We're starting a riot and things can be a bit unpredictable and things can get a bit hairy, so... If we buy some body armour then... Oops. Oh, terrible driving. Not the best handle on this car, but... Yeah. Not an excuse. So, yeah. Things could get a bit messy in this, so we'll... We've got enough ammo to see us through, so... Okay. Let's head down to this... The location, so... Yeah, as I said before, hopefully you can hear me okay. Fourth time lucky, I think, recording this, so... Apart from that weird little glitch on the cutscene, things seem to be going well so far, so fingers crossed the recording comes out okay. Yeah, it just takes me back playing this game. Yeah, it's a lot of fun and... Just talking briefly because we've got a minute or two before we get to the place. Yeah, so GTA San Andreas. So the gameplay was better. You could do more with it. There's much bigger map, much longer game. You know, went into much more depth. Oh, I've got the wrong way. I think. Oh no, here we are. But GTA 4. So what we need to do, we need to punch four people to keep moving as well. Okay, so everyone starts fighting. Carrying what we're saying afterwards. So we're going to shoot this guy because he's going to keep shooting us. And what we're going to try and do... These trucks are really slow, so if there's someone following you, they could potentially pull you out. So we're going to get as close as we can, and then we're going to shoot that one barrel. Just get back a bit. That'll work. There we go. Oops, they're still fighting. Oh, bit of cash.
Thanks for the money. Gonna rip off your same shit down your neck.
All right. Cool. Excellent. So that was nice and easy. I can tell I've done that a few times, can't you now? First time I blew myself up. And I had about 10 health left, which is why I decided to get body armour. It does say that in the game guide too, so yeah, didn't need it this time, but it's good to have it, just in case. So yeah, I'll just head back to Ocean Drive now and save up. If you've watched this all the way to the end, thank you so much for tuning in. I'm sure this is not the most entertaining. Either watch either way I play and me do my commentary, but yeah. If you are watching, I really do appreciate it, thank you. Alright, so let's just pull up here. I might be getting a phone call as well, there we go. Yeah.
Hola, is this Mr. Versetti?
Yeah.
This is Cortez. You were at my party?
Yeah, I remember.
Mr. Versetti, it was a most unfortunate incident that happened with your business deal.
I know.
I want you to know me and my people are doing their utmost to get to the bottom of it. If you you'd like to talk to me more privately, you can find me.
I like this story.
Okay? Good day.
That's like the rudest thing ever.
Okay. So yeah, as I was saying, yeah, so San Andreas was fantastic, but I prefer the storyline and the characters in this game and the music. GTA 4 wasn't a massive fan of, and then GTA 5, which is just, yeah, fantastic. So, okay, so we've saved, we've done all the Ken Rosenberg's missions, so I'm going to leave it there for now. Yeah, thank you very much, take care, and goodbye. Oh, one more call, let's quickly take this.
Get to the payphone next to the mall in Washington.
Okay. Rudely interrupted, but that's unlocked the assassination phone call missions as well, the phone booth ones, so I'll try that again before we get any more calls. Take care, thank you very much, and goodbye.